Christopher Thomas Johnson, was sentenced to death for capital murder in the death of his six-month-old son, Elias Ocean Johnson. Johnson's wife, Dana, gave birth to their son, Elias Ocean Johnson, on August 22, 2004. In February 2005, the Johnsons lived in a duplex in Atmore, Alabama. Born on December 26, 1972, Christopher grew up mostly without a father. An uncle allegedly sexually molested Christopher during his childhood. Christopher was known to have behavioral problems at home and was often suspended from school. Christopher began using alcohol at the age of 12. Christopher dropped out of school during the ninth grade, although he later obtained his GED. At the age of 16, Christopher moved out of his mother's home, began drinking regularly, and using prescription drugs, crack cocaine, powder cocaine, crystal methamphetamine, and marijuana. Christopher alleges that he became sober once he had his son. Prior to the murder, he worked at Swift Supply Company, which provides lumber and building materials. On February 19, 2005, Suzanne Mims and Jason Mims, along with their infant, Sophie, arrived at the Johnson's duplex around 8:30 p.m. to play board games. While playing board games, the Johnsons and the Mims drank alcoholic beverages. At approximately 1 a.m., the Mims left. At around 9 a.m., Dana woke up and found Johnson and Elias on the couch in the duplex. Dana stated that Elias had bruises on him and that he appeared to be dead. At that point, Dana ran over to feel Elias. Dana testified that Elias felt cool, so she tried to check his pulse. However, she could not find one. Worried about Elias, Dana grabbed the telephone and called emergency. Tim Grabill, a paramedic with Atmore Ambulance Service, received a call to go to the Johnson's duplex. When Grabill and his partner, Yareth Hibbert, arrived at the duplex, Johnson was holding Elias. Grabill observed that Elias was very pale, limp, and his extremities were cool to the touch, based on Elias's appearance. Hibbert carried him to the ambulance, where the paramedics checked his vital signs. At that point, Elias was not breathing and had no heartbeat. Although Grabill believed that Elias was already dead, he performed CPR and rushed Elias to the emergency room at Atmore Hospital. When they arrived at the hospital, Grabill carried Elias into the emergency room, still performing CPR, placed him on a trauma bed, and turned him over to Dr. Stephen Michael Sharp. Dr. Sharp testified that Elias appeared to be dead when he arrived at the hospital. Dr. Sharp described several injuries he observed on Elias's body. Specifically, Dr. Sharp noticed several bruises on Elias's face, a bruise on the bridge of Elias's nose, and ruptured blood vessels around Elias's eyes and chin. Dr. Sharp also noticed a bite mark on one of Elias's arms. Although Elias appeared to be dead, the hospital staff attempted to resuscitate him. Because Elias was unresponsive, Dr. Sharp cleared his airway and placed an endotracheal tube in his throat so that medical personnel could breathe for the child. While attempting to place the endotracheal tube, Dr. Sharp noticed blood in Elias's mouth. Dr. Sharp also testified that Elias had blood in his stomach. After all attempts to resuscitate Elias failed, he was pronounced dead. Investigator Chuck Brooks and Police Chief Jason Dean, with the Atmore Police Department, went to Atmore Hospital to investigate the circumstances of Eliza's death. One of the law enforcement officers asked Johnson and Dana to come to the police station and give statements relating to the death of their child. Dana rode to the police station with a member of her church, and Johnson rode to the police station with Chief Dean. During the ride to the police station, Johnson spontaneously stated that he had something to do with Elias's death. Once at the police station, Johnson gave a statement to investigator Brooks and Irene Johnson, a social worker with the Alabama Department of Human Resources. After being informed of and waiving his Miranda rights, Johnson indicated that Elias had been crying, so Johnson laid on top of him to try to quiet the child. When Elias did not stop crying, Johnson stuck his fingers in the child's mouth and hit him. Johnson stated that last night was the hardest that he ever hit Elias, and he was pretty sure Elias's death was his fault. Johnson also stated that after the event that night, he did not think that he had seriously injured Elias. Dr. Kathleen Entis, a medical examiner who was formerly with the Alabama Department of Forensic Sciences, performed the autopsy on Elias and testified that it would be reasonable to estimate that Elias had suffered 85 separate injuries, including a bite mark on his arm. Dr. Entis testified that Elias had multiple bruises on his face and head. She stated that both of Elias's ears were swollen and bruised, which was consistent with a boxing blow and squeezing. Dr. Entis testified that Elias's lower lip was swollen and bloody from a blunt force injury. Dr. Entis explained that Elias had 3 impact injuries to his forehead. She informed the jury that Elias's ethmoid bone, which is in the sinuses, was broken and that Elias's sinuses were full of blood. Dr. Entis testified that Elias had deep contusions on his head and that his brain had hemorrhaged as a result of blunt force trauma. Dr. Entis also testified that Elias had hemorrhages in both eyes and had injuries to his inner lips and nose that indicated that he had been smothered by the forceful covering, sealing off of his mouth and nose. According to Dr. Entis, Elias's injuries had been inflicted within 24 hours of his death. Dr. Entis finally testified that in her opinion, Elias died as a result of blunt force trauma and smothering. In addition to the state's evidence, Johnson testified that he intentionally murdered his son because he hated his wife. Johnson explained that he would have left his wife long before the murder if it had not been for Elias. According to Johnson, he did not want to worry about her threats of putting me in jail for alimony or child support, so he intentionally inflicted wounds on Elias that caused Elias's life to expire. Johnson stated that his final words to Elias were, "You go see Jesus." Johnson's ex-wife Dana said that she welcomes Christopher's death. "Although I normally do not agree with capital punishment, I will not lose any sleep over this particular execution. Whether it is right or wrong, I feel that a weight will be lifted from my soul, and finally I will feel relief. I am scarred by this, and Christopher took away my son, my trust in other people, and even my desire to ever have another child. I still have a hard time being around children because of the sorrow it makes me feel. Every day I see children that are Elias's age, and I wonder what he would have been like. She has since moved away and is studying to become a nurse. My son was the most delightful, calm little boy I have ever known." Christopher Johnson took him from me. I have spent years trying to heal from this unimaginable pain, she said. Christopher Thomas Johnson was executed by the state of Alabama on October 20, 2011. Christopher was pronounced dead at 6:25 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, inside the execution chamber at the Hellman Correctional Facility in Atmore, Alabama. Christopher was 38 years of age. Christopher had asked that his appeals be halted, which allowed his execution to proceed. Christopher spent the last 5 years of his life on Alabama's death row. Thank you for watching Death Row.